It's exciting and it's emotional because you're here to help us. It's that human touch that is so needed right now.
As the waters recede along Florida's southwest coast, the damage is beginning to surface. It's why recovery efforts at churches in Cape Coral, Port Charlotte, DeLand, and here in Naples are ramping up. It's a virtual beehive of activity with hundreds of people in their familiar yellow shirts.
This command center was set up literally overnight.
They're volunteers, most of them from The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, and their meeting house will be a temporary command center for the next few weekends.
Anytime that we have a disaster, the church has developed the ability to organize very quickly. They pushed 800 people through here this morning, getting supplies and going out into the neighborhoods to help with the cleanup.
All of this to answer the call for help in the aftermath of Hurricane Ian.
The storm surge came in fast. It was shocking. It hit Collier at high tide, 225. So the water is coming in. Now it wants to recede. The wind is coming from the south-southeast, pushing that water back, and that's why we all flooded so badly. To come in and get people ready for repair is critical. It's critical to get those baseboards out, to get that house mucked up, to get the furniture that was damaged out on the road is critical. However, we are a resilient community and people are helping people like your church. I mean, that's who I called on. And I remember what you did during Irma. And here you are again. And we're just so grateful.
Many of the volunteers came from all over Florida. They camped overnight and they're ready to go, as Alex Mendoza and Rafael Brioso explain.
I'm excited because this is the first time I'm gonna have my son with me as well.
Anything we can do to help and serve, you know, we're in the Miami South Stake and we've been affected ourselves by hurricanes many, many times. And it's amazing to receive the help, especially when you need it. And having done this before in Key West for Irma, you know, it's a wonderful experience for both the receiver, but also ourselves who are lending that service and being able to help.
The command center functions like a well-oiled machine. A network of congregations known as stakes contribute to the effort.
To run the command center, everything that you see back here, all the electronics, all of the computers, all the communication, all this setup is done between the coordination of this good stake president and this great stake president.
First, volunteers check in. Each team is given an assignment called a work order. Then, depending on the need, they'll pick up supplies, shovels, gloves, and chainsaws as they head out into the community.
Well, right now, we're headed over to Bonita Springs. I spoke with a man by the name of William, and he was so grateful. As a matter of fact, he told me he was out in his lawn in his yard right now trying to cut down trees, and he needed chainsaws. And he was so happy to hear that we have the equipment, the manpower, and the chainsaws to help them out.
Once on site, volunteers go straight to work, young and old, parents and children, like Rafael and his son.
This is my mother's house. She's 95 years old. I think it's wonderful. I would have never been able to do all of that by myself.
South of here in Everglades City, residents at a mobile home park also have some welcome visitors.
So many people are elderly here, and I can't tell you how much everyone appreciates for the outside to come in and help.
I just do what I can do, but I wouldn't have been able to have done this. I couldn't. I just physically couldn't do it. So, like I said, you're angels to me. Every one of you. You've got a halo over the top of all your heads.
At a neighborhood in Fort Myers, almost everyone's furniture and belongings are now in trash piles on the street. Cars and homes were submerged up to the rooftops, and it's a race against the clock to prevent mold from growing.
You just see mounds of, you know, people's belongings, beds, dressers. But one of the favorite parts for me is seeing people out. It's just been a comfort to know that people still care for each other.
That's one of the glorious things about charity. We all start out as strangers, and then we become friends.
Katie Osborne is here with members of her small young adult congregation known as a branch. The group includes branch president Cesar Rincon and his wife Claudia.
We got to this command center about 9 o'clock. They give us this order, and here we go. We didn't know what to expect, really. They told us, you have to move things from the house. Okay, but as you see, it's been an amazing day.
It's rewarding, it makes you feel better. At least we're doing a little bit for someone.
Volunteers will work through the weekend. Usually, Latter-day Saints rest from physical activity and work on Sundays to focus on personal worship. But this week, their worship looks a little different.
When that happens, we are filled with compassion and driven to act.
A brief sacrament meeting is held before everyone heads out for a few more hours of service. Their support is deeply felt by residents like Diane Burt, who lost almost everything except a few precious items.
I threw away album after album. I have family here. There's 5 homes involved, and we were all pretty much destroyed as far as the flooding. Everything, of course, is wet and soggy, and the sewers started to come in. What I've been doing is a pile for garbage, a pile for what I want to keep, pictures. I peel them off the albums and lay them out to dry, trying to save those and anything of importance, family related, and just scrambling to help myself, my brother, my mom.
Thanks to these volunteers, Diane doesn't have to carry her load alone. They're giving her the extra boost she needs to care for her family.
Oh my gosh, it's been, I just can't even tell you, it's so nice, you know, helpful. Because you can't be in 5 places at one time. So that's wonderful.
You've lost your possessions, maybe photographs, special mementos, and they're all on the curbside, and someone comes and knocks on the door and says, I'm here to help you. That's the human element. That's the reaching out person to person that's going to help this community heal.